Right, in this video, we're going to talk about the hardware components for the Lego WeDo kit. So you'll get 10 of these kits with your STEM Teach for All gear that arrives at your school. So you get the 10 blue, and they'll all be in the same case together. So one of the first things you need to consider is how you're going to charge these kits. So the kit comes with one of these 10-port multi-chargers with these circle plugs. They simply plug into the front of one of your Lego WeDo bricks. You'll find two circle holes here, and you just plug them in there. Now, one of the things at the end of your lesson, when you want to go charge these up, the students will probably go to put these back. They will probably arrive in the bottom of the kit, but a really good way to charge them between lessons is just to grab all 10, join them together in a big row, and then just get all 10 and plug them into your charger in a series. That way it just makes your life a little bit easier when it comes to charging your gear. One other thing you'll notice when the gear arrives, now they'd have just come from another school, so they may be a little bit messed up. So you might want to spend a few minutes at the start of your time with the kit and just sort of sort them out. Grab a few students and sit down and sort out the trays as best you can back into a working order, ready to use them with your students in your classroom. So the first thing I want to draw your attention to is this smart brick. So this smart brick is the brains of your operation. This is what we connect all our Lego pieces to in order to make them robotic. In the bottom of the kit, you may also see one of these trays. Now this is a these ones here are rechargeable. These ones here can have standard batteries put in. So for whatever reason that you have any issues, you can put some AA batteries in here and they will work just as this smart hub does. Very, very easy to swap these out. You can just click here, just a little bit of pressure on the front and they separate. So that's your rechargeable battery pack. This one is to add AA's to. But for the most part, you want to leave them in for rechargeable battery use. On your smart hub, you'll notice a green button on the top. When we press that green button, it makes it available to be seen by the iPad for connection. Another important feature of these smart hubs here on the back, you'll notice there are two ports that you can connect your sensors and your motors to. Now, the each smart hub that you get will also be a sticker on the side. Now, my one I have here today doesn't have a sticker, but the ones that you'll get at your school will say, my name is, and it'll offer a color. That's really important, so when you do go to join your smart hubs to your iPad, they're all individually named, and they're all named the same thing. So it'll save the confusion amongst the students by making sure you check that name before you get into connecting your robot. Now, the Lego tub itself is the next part that I want to talk about today. So in our Lego tub here, there will be 280 different Lego pieces in your Lego WeDo kit. So I'll just take the top off. And you'll notice here, you'll get the white tray in the top. One other thing to note, I'll just flip it around this way, is that each section has a sticker to show you what parts go in which hole. So that really helps when you get to sorting out the differences in your where all the parts go. Now they will get a little bit messed up at the time at the school, but that's totally okay. For the most part, if they can try and get them in some sort of working order, that'll work really well. Now the students will need to lift out the white tray at some point. Now this generally may get kicked over at some point by accident, but just remind the students to be carefully moving that white tray out, because in the bottom of the kit will come a few important items. There'll be things like sensors and wheels and things like that in the bottom of the kit, and these are all really important. So I usually find in the classroom, before I start a build, if it's going to be a driving robot, I'll go in, I'll get my wheels out, I'll grab out my sensors and my motor. It's a good idea to pop that white tray back in the top. Another important feature when we talk about using the kit is this plastic lid. So in this plastic lid, you have a lip here around the outside, and I always like to tell the students, build your robot on the lid. That way, it'll stop our pieces from getting scattered across the room a little bit. I've seen some schools use things like hula hoops as well. You must stay inside that space just to try and stop parts from getting all mixed up. So yeah, when you go to do your build, you make sure you keep your parts here on the lid, because it's just a really good, nice, safe space to start building your robot. So in the bottom of the kit, when you first get it, that's where you may find these smart hubs. There should be two large wheels, a couple of small wheels, which the driving robots are really, really popular to build. There will be a motor, which you will use for a lot of the different builds that you'll do. So this is your output. And there'll also be two sensors in here. There is this one, which is called a tilt sensor, and you'll notice it by, because it has these arrows on the side. Now this sensor can detect movement from side to side as your build gets moved around. So we'll use that as an input, and I'll show you how to use that in a later video. And then you have this one. This is a distance sensor, and it looks like it's got two little eyes. That's how I know that it's the distance sensor, and that's the other one you'll find in the bottom. Now with your smart brick, there are only two holes. So for the most part, you will have the motor plugged into one and one of these two sensors at any one time. There could be certain builds where you might plug both sensors in, but for the most part, you're going to use the motor and a sensor as part of your build. So that's just a quick overview of the kit. Like I said, there's 280 pieces in this kit to do your different Lego builds. On the back of, you'll get this cardboard sheet that comes in here. You do not want to, don't throw this away. This is important because it gives you a little breakdown of exactly how this kit is organized as well. So especially at the end of your time with the kit, make a whole bunch of photocopies of these, spread them around the students in the classroom that are helping you organize them, and try and get everything back in the kit as best you can. That cardboard sheet can be very, very helpful, but during your build, I like just to tuck it underneath the box. Now, one of the things you will find whenever time you work with Lego is missing pieces. You will find missing pieces all the way across your classroom all the time, and it's going to be really hard to find out which kit did that missing piece come out of. So as a good little classroom management tool, I like to have a container or a plastic bag somewhere at the front of the classroom, and if you, at the end of the lesson, if you find any pieces on the floor, those missing pieces go in there, and that's your first port of call to go and find any missing bits. One other thing to note when you are doing your builds is that certain parts of these kits are more cosmetic. So they're just to make it look good, like eyes and flowers and things like that. So if you are missing them, don't worry too much. You're mostly concerned about those core features and those core building blocks to build your robots. And you'll discover that as you go through the builds over time, which pieces are really important and which ones aren't. But at any time, if you're ever missing any pieces, make sure you log it on our STEM T4O website under the Report and Issue tab. And to finish off the, when you're finished with these kits, as I said, it's really good to organize the best as you can back into those packs and put them in the kit ready to be transported off to the next school.
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEM T4L Facebook community? It's a closed group. You can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.